This is FidoOS, the best operating system for any PC or laptop. If your PC or laptop is not compatible with Chrome OS, then FidoOS is the alternative OS you need to install on your PC that delivers a similar experience to Chrome OS for free of cost. FidoOS is designed to be fast, secure, and easy to use. It's an open source operating system based on the Chromium OS project. The main goal of FidoOS is to deliver a better experience of Chrome OS with added flexibility and support for running Android applications on Linux distributions. FidoOS is super lightweight operating system that primarily focuses on web-based applications and services. This makes it an ideal choice for users browsing the web and using productivity applications. Now, due to its lightweight nature, FidoOS can run on any older PC or laptop without any issues. The simple user interface of FidoOS allows you to personalize the look and feel. You can change the wallpaper, adjust the taskbar, dock, and more. One of the amazing things about FidoOS is that it lets you run Android applications. Along with that, you can run Debian using CrossVM, which lets you leverage the power of FidoOS. Now, this is why you can run Linux desktop applications like Android Studio, VS Code, Blender, and more. Now, that being said, it's time to start installing FidoOS. The only requirement for this video, you need a computer running Windows, Linux, or macOS. Also, you need an 8 gigs or higher pen drive. For demonstration, I'm going to use my gaming laptop and show you how to install FidoOS. The procedure is the same for any computer. Now, as you can see, it's currently running Arch Linux. I'm going to replace it with FidoOS in a moment. Then, I'm going to head over to this website and download the latest version of FidoOS. If you have an Intel PC with iGPU that falls between the 3rd to 8th generation, choose the first option. If you have an Intel PC with iGPU that falls between the 9th to 12th generation, choose the second option. Lastly, if you have an Intel or AMD CPU with a graphics card, choose the last option. Next, head over to this website and download the Balena Etcher and install it. Now go ahead and connect the USB drive to your PC or laptop. Once it's connected, open Balena Etcher. Then choose Flash from the file and import the FidoOS. Now select the USB drive and click on Flash. Sit back and relax. The flashing process will take a few minutes depending on the writing speed of your USB drive. Now go ahead and reboot your computer. While it's rebooting, you need to enter into BIOS settings. Now use the keyboard shortcut based on your motherboard. It mostly could be F2, F9, or Escape key. The first thing to do after entering into BIOS is to enable USB boot. Then change the boot order by setting the USB drive as the primary boot. Now go ahead and disable secure boot, which is very, very important. It's also better to clear any keys or certificates after disabling the secure boot. Now this way it won't cause any installation problems with FidoOS. Once it's done, save the changes. Your system will boot into FidoOS from the USB drive. If in case it fails to boot, use the boot menu to load FidoOS install media. Now when you're inside the live setup of FidoOS, go ahead and choose your language and keyboard layout. Then the FidoOS installer will present two options. Install FidoOS or try it before installing. It's always better practice to try it before installing it and see how it works. But for now, I will choose the install option. If you want to install a fresh copy of FidoOS and replace it with the existing OS, choose the first option. If you're installing FidoOS alongside with Windows or Linux, choose the multi-boot installation. I'm going to choose the full disk installation that erases everything and installs FidoWAS. Then select the target drive. Sit back and relax. The installation will take some time depending on the speed of the drive. Once it's done, go ahead and shut down your computer. Then remove the USB drive. When the screen goes black, press the power button to turn on the computer to boot FidoWAS. Once you're inside FidoWAS, the first thing to do is to enable the Android subsystem. You may see a notification to install it. You can also use the start menu and choose Android. Accept the terms and conditions and install the Android subsystem. Once it's installed, head over to the Start menu and open App Store. Then install OpenG Apps to enable Google Play services. Once it's enabled, restart your PC. Now you will get access to the Google Play Store. Go ahead and log in with your Google account. Now you can install Android applications and video games. I tried Temple Run 2, Asphalt 9, it works fine. To exit from Android application, take your cursor to the top bar to see the window controls. It's time to set up a Linux subsystem that helps to run desktop applications like VS Code, Android Studio, and more. Head over to Start menu, open the terminal, and click on Setup. Now this will take you to the Settings page and choose to turn on the Linux environment. Now using the Setup screen, you need to create a virtual machine. Allocate the desired space for the Linux system and click on Install. Wait for a few minutes to finish the installation of Debian Linux. Once it's done, you can see a terminal. Go ahead and update the system by running this command. Once it's done, you can install any application or package. If you have installed GUI applications, they will automatically add to the start menu of FidoWAS. It's also recommended to set up a Flatpak to install more applications. To do so, enter into super user mode by running this command. Then type this command to install Flatpak. While it's installing, go to this page, choose Debian, and copy the FlatHub repository URL. Once the Flatpak installation is done, paste the line over here. Now you can install any application like VS Code, Android Studio using the Flatpak, and it works next level without any issues. And that's pretty much it. This is how you install FidoOS on any PC or laptop. Let me know what do you think about it. If you have any queries or suggestions, do let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching my video. This has been KSK Ryle. I will see you in the next one.